see so many different people, so many different attitudes, so that creates so many different facets. Spike has his own attitude, I have my own attitude. It's hard, man, and who really is qualified to judge art but the audience, you know? And if Spike makes a movie and people go and they like it and somebody don't like it, then it's not for the person that doesn't like it. I know he wanted people to like it. Boys in the Hood was made to make people like it, some people don't. But I don't think anybody makes a rep movie attempt to make people angry or cause violence or none of that. You'd have to be an idiot. Yeah. I think most people are trying to create dark conversation. That's when you need to get it together. So I don't really try to make a cast judgment on art. If it makes you feel good, then it's good. If it doesn't, then it wasn't for you.
Well, the funny thing about the Boys in the Hood thing is that it's been put out in all the press, all their press releases and everything. Like, this is an anti-gang movie and blah, 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 and everything. And yet, the media doesn't seem to see it that way. And certainly, a lot of the audiences around the country haven't seen it that way either. Because it's like, the gang wars.
Yeah, but the gang wars don't come from the movie. The gang wars come from the fact that the movie draws the gang members together. I mean, I could give away sneakers and we'll have 10 people killed here and invite gang members. They don't care. It's not the sneakers. It's just the fact that they're gang members. And when they see somebody that they don't dig, they shoot them. That's what a gang member does, kill each other. So, I'm like, we're blending on the movie. We can give away color TVs in L.A. and get more people shot. The media, they try to self-pay. The media, you know, only press I would trust is a free press. But anything that comes on TV that needs ratings to stay on, it's going for the hype. It's got it. Fire me, put me and you in a jail cell, I'll kill you over a cigarette.
But it's the same people, though, that are, like, in the same neighborhood.
Doesn't matter. You put me in the jail cell with you, me and you could be brothers. I'll kill you over a cigarette. It has nothing to do with it. It's poverty. It's a sense of I don't have and you got. The Jungle Creed says the strong must feed on any prey of the hungry. That's the law of the jungle. So if you're in the ghetto and you shine and I want to wear my Rolex, I better carry a gun because everybody else is broke. And they gonna come to get me. Now, you might say a sneaker sounds stupid, but a sneaker might be a $100 pair of sneakers. Everybody else is wearing $10 pair of sneakers. I want them. You know, white people kill white people. You know, it's poverty and it's money. And it's just the way that people are taught in this country that material things are worth killing over. It's a war. Thousands of people have died on each side of the gang thing. To say that gangs are stupid in New York is like saying, well, why don't they just stop the war in Northern Ireland? Why don't they stop the war in the Middle East? Because it's a war. Once I kill somebody on your side and you kill me, it's murder. Murder creates a type of energy that is illogical. And it's murder. Gangs ain't out fighting, they're killing. You can't stop murder once it started. You have to create a truce. You have to slow it down. But that's why the last verse of Colors is, my color's death, though we all want peace. But this war will end when all wars cease. Meaning, those people who say it's stupid, go to any other war and snap your fingers. It's just all wars are dumb. But that war is no more dumb than any other war. It's like a feud that happens.